Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome back to Let's Play King's Quest II, Romancing the Stones. I've got to start my timer here. Or my stopwatch, rather. Okay. I could not figure out what to do in this area.
You feel no wind, not even the slightest breeze. This is very strange indeed. They are too heavy to move. You thought the mountainside in Kalima was unclimbable. That would seem easy now in comparison to climbing this. The waterfall is out of reach. They are too heavy to move. You have no need to carry water.
So, I figured, well, maybe I could swim in here. But, I don't think... Yeah.
You attempt to remain afloat in the unusual water. However, due to its salt content and strong undercurrent, you sink. And sink. And sink.
And sink.
The undercurrent pulls you under. The last thing you see are your hopes rising to the surface.
That and the bubbles of my last exhaled breath. So what I found out you have to do, you have to catch this fish. Which is... can be difficult. Or maybe not.
You retrieve the empty net. You don't seem to be able to catch anything at the moment.
Where are you? Gotcha.
You cast the net into the tranquil sea. Upon retrieving it, you see that you have caught a large golden fish.
I see.
It falls from the net and flops helplessly on the beach.
Let's take a look at this thing.
The large fish is covered with shimmering golden scales. Its graceful fins and tail are almost translucent. Right now, the beautiful fish is writhing in agony.
Writhing in agony. Let's poke it.
You grab the flopping fish. Its mouth is wide open and its gills are extended. With great difficulty, you hold the fish as it twists and turns in your hands. The fish gasps for air. If it does have anything to say, it cannot speak right now.
Alright, so... what you gotta do... we don't actually have this in our inventory.
You toss the fish back into the tranquil sea.
You do that. Who would have thunk it?
Thank you for not killing me. For your kindness, I will gladly take you across to the other side of this vast sea.
It's an alien.
The beautiful golden fish is awaiting you to climb on its back.
Let's see. Will it talk more?
Come, grab hold of my fins and I will take you across this ocean.
What's your name?
Come.
Your name is Come?
You carefully lower yourself down the steep embankment and slide under the fish's scaly back. You hold on tight as the fish swims far out to sea.
Whee! What if it tastes like grape juice? Look at those trees.
You slide off the fish's back and clamber onto the sandy shore of a surreal little island.
Thank you, fishy.
Although the water looks calm on the surface, there are dangerous undercurrents at work here. The trees on this small island are tall, with spreading branches and huge fan-like leaves. The rocks
the
on
rocks.
This island appear to contain large amounts of quartz. The trees on this...
I You get some quartz?
A closer examination of the rocks confirms that they are indeed made of quartz.
Let's cut off some quartz.
Brandishing your sword.
Never mind.
Brandishing.
You chop down a tree either.
You can see that the island is really quite small. The foliage is remarkable, though. Plants and flowers have overgrown it, some growing very large in contrast to the tiny island. The sky above the surreal world is a brilliant orange.
All right.
The trees on this small island. You can see that the island is. The trees on this.
Ooh, there's the tower.
2 lion statues are situated on either side of the door. It almost looks like they are guarding the entrance.
I'm talking about almost. They obviously are guarding the entrance.
The tower is built of creamy, opaque quartz blocks. You see a large window near the top. The thick door is fashioned from a wood unknown to you. The rocks on this The topaz sand shimmers beneath your feet.
Alright, poke the lion. Let me save before I start messing with this.
The statues have been carved from some unknown type of rock. There are no footholds or handholds in the tower walls. It would be impossible to climb it.
What say the lion statues?
The statue does not respond. The statue does not respond.
I don't suppose we can just come over and, like, open the door, right? Oh.
The hollow is not very deep. There is no obvious way to open the door. There is no...
Okay.
The center of the door is hollow, about the size of a small stone.
Okay, so we need a stone.
A disc-like indentation has been carved into the door. It appears as if something is supposed to be placed there. A disc... Upon closer examination, you see that the door contains several ring-shaped indentations surrounding a small hole in the very center.
So we need some kind of ridged... circular stone. Okay.
The topaz sand. The rocks. Although the water. The trees on the.
Yeah, we're just looking around here. Been here. Oh, this looks like a different color from the rest of the sand.
You can see that the island is really quite small. This sand patch has a unique color.
Poke it.
You hold your finger up in the air. You feel no wind, not even the slightest breeze. This is very strange indeed.
So why is this a different color? Oh, interesting. Excuse me.
Some writing has appeared in the sand. It reads,
"It would appear that you, my dear, are here indeed to help me. Walk to this sand and place your hand upon these words, and you'll see."
Okay. So we've discovered that she likes to sing and she's a poet.
You place your palm upon the words in the sand.
Whoa. What the hell is that? There's something over on the other island, too. Oh, I got teleported over there.
You notice some more writing in the sand near the portal. It reads,
"You may return, but pause to learn a way to flee this cursed place. My end draws near, so hurry, dear, and come swift to me in haste.
Okay, so she wants me to pause to learn, but she wants me to come swift to her. I don't know.
This portal leads back to the larger island. The writing in the sand reads, "The strangely colored bushes also grow here on the smaller island. You are standing on a small island. There doesn't seem to be much of interest here, except the portal you've opened."
There's another patch of discolored sand.
The sand patch is an odd color. A chunk of quartz rock rests on the sand.
Okay, possibly this is what would fit into that indentation in a door.
You pick up the beautiful stone of quartz.
Yes, I do.
The beauty of the quartz stone is truly remarkable. The sky's radiant haze reflects off the quartz stone as you turn it in your hand.
Okay.
You hold your finger up.
Let's take a look at this now. Okay, I gotta walk on there.
Three symbols are depicted in the sand. Perhaps each one represents an action that must be performed in order to establish an escape route from this strange place.
Okay. Container, water, put water in container, pour on, I guess, these lines. You have something like that? Probably not this.
Don't throw that into the sea, Graham.
Yeah, Graham. Well, I don't have a container like that. Find one.
A swirling blue portal has opened in the sand. The small island offshore has only a few bushes and palm trees growing on it.
Okay, well, let's see if I can find anything that would be helpful in gathering water. I just get closer and closer.
The rocks on the small island.
Interesting.
The rock. The island is completely overgrown with foliage. Huge leaves, flowers, and clinging vines are everywhere. The rocks on this.
Okay.
The rocks.
Rocks.
The rock.
The rock. The rock.
The rocks. You can see that the island is really
quite remarkable, yes. Okay. Well, I don't know. It said pause to learn, but. Hold on a second. See what branches off of me. Yeah, I've been there. Behind the tower, Graham. Alright, well, never mind. Pause to learn. I don't know. I'll try this.
The disc fits perfectly into the outer ring on the door. The thick door is fashioned from a wood unknown to you. a year on, and you still look pretty darn good. The beauty of the quartz stone is truly remarkable.
Okay, I have to get out of my own way here. Ah, not off screen.
As you insert the quartz stone into the hollow, you hear it lock into place. Suddenly, the statues rumble to life.
Hello, statues.
The truth you will find from one satisfied, for the other can only be lying. These words will provide you the means to get by. My companion Zoe shall see you dying.
Great.
Twin lion statues are...
They are guarding.
The statue...
speaketh?
If you were to ask my companion if he knows the way through this door, he would answer, no. The first gave birth to all life. The second allows it to thrive. The third sustains all that wander it. The fourth will once a day hide.
What? He doesn't know the way through the door, but...
You could talk to your...
If you were to ask... The first gave birth to all life.
Water?
The second allows it to thrive. The third sustains
Air?
All that wander it. The
Earth?
Fourth will once a day hide.
Air?
If you were to ask my companion if he knows the way through this door, he would answer, yes. The first carries all manner of weather.
Air.
The second gives cause to be burned.
Fire.
The third is shallow, as it can be deep. The fourth, to bear fruit, must be turned.
Earth is the last one. Shallow is, would be water.
If you would... The first carries all manner of...
Shallow as it can be deep.
If you were to ask the first gave...
Alright, so what am I supposed to do here?
The brilliant quartz stone has been locked into the hollow. It is a symbol of the sun. It is a symbol of a water drop. It is a symbol of a cloud. It is a symbol of a mountain of earth. A golden disc now sits in the outer ring of the wooden door.
Okay, well, one of them's right and one of them's wrong. I hope by clicking outside the puzzle I reset it. I did hit the top one first.
The step.
Alright, so, my little pen here.
If you were to ask my the first carries all manner of weather.
Air.
The second gives cause to be burned.
Fire.
The third is shallow, as it can be deep.
Water.
The fourth, to bear fruit, must be turned.
Earth. Okay, so... Air or a cloud? And fire or sun? Water? Earth.
You do not know yet if you can leave this place. You'd better see to that problem first.
Yeah, huh. Well, this might be the correct answer. What happens if I follow the other instruction? Is that the one that kills me?
If you were to ask my... The first gave birth to all life.
Water.
The second allows it to thrive.
Sun.
The third sustains all that wander it.
Earth.
The fourth will once a day hide.
Maybe that's the sun. Once a day hide is the sun. I didn't mean to talk to him.
If you would... The first gave birth to all life. The second allows it to thrive.
Air.
The third sustains all that wander it. The fourth will once a day hide.
Okay, so... if I try his instruction...
The door is locked. The door...
Oh. Okay. Well, I guess I've done it? I don't know.
The thick door is...
What do I have to click on this thing? Okay. Water. Air. Earth. Sun.
Uh-oh. You feel the sand beneath you starting to suck at your feet.
That's the killing one.
Sucked in again, Bram.
Okay, so it's the right one. I had it right the first time. Well, I'm here, so let me just go. Air. Fire. Water. Earth.
You do not know yet if you can leave this place.
Okay. Disc is solved. I need to look around and find something. Can I wander off here?
You attempt to remain a f-
Ah.
The undercurrent pulls you under. The last thing you s-
Okay. Basically, this is the front of the tower. So what's this? Is there something behind that?
The trees are too difficult to climb because of their odd shapes and size.
Sizes. Looking everywhere.
A closer examination. The plants, and their leaves in particular, do have an interesting shape. However, the plants are too firmly attached to the ground to uproot. A closer
So, what am I supposed to be finding here? The tower back down here? Yep, okay. Oh, well, I can't go behind the tower without going into the next screen. Okay. I'm not sure what I'm missing here. One of these trees have a coconut?
The trees are... The plants and their leaves and...
That's weird.
You have no need to carry water. The trees are too deep.
You have no need to carry water. So what is that thing trying to tell me? I thought I had to put water in it and pour water somewhere. Where is that thing? Okay. Go back in here.
You call into the portal, but your voice is quickly absorbed.
Coconuts up there.
You can't reach the coconuts from down here.
Yeah, well. What do I have that can...
Brandishing your sword. Brandishing.
Are they enchanted coconuts?
That is not enchanted. That is not...
I think that's enchanted. can I use this to loop?
You can't use...
No. Isn't it?
You can't... You can't...
Pretty limited with me. I can't climb this? Maybe I can climb it. Oh, I can just climb it, duh. Go up. Let's take a look at this.
A tall palm tree stands on this small island. It looks climbable. You see that some coconuts have grown at the top of the tree.
Take.
You remove an ample-sized coconut from the bunch growing in the treetop.
Ample?
You hold your finger up in the air.
Alright, I just have to go down. Okay. Let's take a look at this thing.
The coconut is a hairy ball.
You did not just say that.
The outside feels round and hairy.
That's just as bad. Alright, we're gonna cut
this. You feel the weight of your ancient weapon.
Alright, I'm not doing the weight thing. I'm just gonna cut it.
Using the sharp blade of your sword, you slice the coconut clean in half.
Okay.
You have a hairy, dome-shaped coconut. The outside feels round and hairy.
Okay, let's fill it with some water.
You fill the half coconut with briny water from the magenta sea.
Let's see how it looks like now.
You have a hairy, dome-shaped coconut filled with magenta seawater. The outside feels round, hairy, and wet.
And wet. Okay, so... The little diagram over there, so I had to pour water... on this?
You can't use that there.
On this. And this will be a portal out?
Some writing has appeared in the sand where the symbols used to be. It reads,
"Well done, my dear. You've come so near. A king's quest is soon to end.
King's quest.
But if now you go, alone you'd know, our broken path would ne'er mend."
Suddenly, the sand begins swirling again. In place of the poem, appears yet another portal.
Ta-da!
The portal continues to swirl rapidly, beckoning you to enter it. Sand particles flick all around wherever they are disturbed. You call into the portal, but your voice is quickly absorbed.
Okay, I'm gonna quickly save and see what happens if I go through that portal. It'll even let me.
You've exited this strange world. With no way of returning, you can kiss your fair lady goodbye. And even that is now impossible.
Jane. Alright guys, well thanks for watching. I'm going to head back through the other portal and see if we can get in that tower now. See you next time. Bye-bye.